Hello and welcome to TWIH. This is the Eastern Conference preview, which means it's the Will Tampa Bay win it all preview. And they probably will. They're, if not the best team in history, one of the best teams in history, for sure. And they're definitely making out of the first round because it's Columbus, and Columbus is bad. They maybe play Boston in the second round. That's probably the best team, or the team with the best chance to beat them. And if they get past the second round, then it's probably no problem for them then on out, unless they get serious injuries. But, you know, this is Tampa's world. We're just living in it. So we'll just see. Just wait and see. So Washington certainly has elite talent at all the levels. They've got Obi. They've got Backstrom. They've got Oshie. They've got Kuznetsov. They've got Carlson and Niskanen and Holtby, did I say? They're covered. Their underlying numbers aren't that good, but their elite talent pushes them over the hump. They took the season series against Carolina, so really it's their series to lose on this one. Carolina has always been a good possession team, but their shitty goaltending has always sunk their season. This year they finally have good goaltending, and hey, look at that, they're in the playoffs. But unfortunately, they're going in the playoffs against a team that beat them in every game in the whole season, in the regular season. And they just don't have the elite talent that Washington does to get them over the hump. So, sorry, Carolina, this is a one-round exit for you. The Columbus Blue Jackets are back in the playoffs after going all in and making a serious push by getting Matt Duchene and Ryan Dzingel at the trade deadline and keeping Bobrovsky and Panarin. They want to go far, and the farthest they're going to go is the first round, because John Tortorella is very good at not getting the full potential out of his teams. This team should go deep in the playoffs, but they just don't. They just fall flat all the time. Is it the Matt Duchene curse? I don't know. I think it's really the Torts curse, man. I'd rather hear Torts curse than have him curse his actual team. Sorry, CBJ, you're out. Okay, the Tampa Bay Lightning are very good. They seriously are one of the better teams in history. They have 62 wins, tying whoever, was it Detroit or Montreal? I don't remember. One of the other greatest teams in history. These guys are too good, man. Hedman is injured going into the playoffs, but it's not going to matter because their whole team can just keep doing what it's doing. John Cooper should win the Jack Adams for keeping this team chugging along all 82 games. You know, it's just a matter of time till these guys get to the final. And this series is going to be one of the short ones, that's for sure. The New York Islanders aren't as shitty as we all thought they would be. That's because Barry Trotz and the two goalies, Lehner and Greiss, held an above-average save percentage most of the year. So that's going to keep the goals from getting in your net. They, in fact, allowed the fewest goals against all season in the entire league. And that's kind of all they got going for them. They've got a couple good forwards, but two good forwards aren't going to win a whole playoff series for you. So let's see how many goals they can limit, because I don't think it'll be enough. The Pittsburgh Penguins have had an up-and-down season, that's for sure, but they look like they're on the up right about now. Matt Murray's playing very well, their puck possession game is a lot better, and it looks like their big guys are going to be healthy. Malkin and Letang just had a period of absence, but they both came back for the last couple games, and they look to be healthy for the playoffs, so that spells trouble for the Islanders, because they ain't got shit to handle that, really. It's just a matter of time before the Penguins grind them down. Maybe five games, in fact. Oh, I put six. Six games. The Toronto Maple Leafs have a stacked offense, but have a thin defense. They got a couple of studs back there, but the rest are slow and old. And Mike Babcock likes to play the slow and old guys. Mike Babcock was perennially like the best coach in the league, but maybe that's not actually the case. And we just kind of had rose-colored glasses when he was on those Detroit clubs with the great fucking future Hall of Famers on them. Yeah, maybe that's a little bit. I don't think Toronto is going to last against Boston this time around. Boston could very well be the second best team in the East, and I think that's pretty much true. Their top line of Bergeron, Marchand, and Pasternak is really good. They're a good possession team. They've got a solid defense. They've got Tuukka Rask in net. Like, they have all the makings of a deep, contending cup team. It all depends on if they can get past Toronto, which, yeah, they probably will. And then they face Tampa Bay in the second round. And that's the true test, and they seem to be the only team that could maybe do it. So let's see, Boston. Let's see what you can do. I kind of really want Columbus to go down in like crazy fashion, to just be blown out in four straight games, just so they can fire Tortorella and have him just go off. Like, that would be a great press conference. I just want to see Tortorella get back to his old school angry level days and just like be totally embarrassed and just get in front of a mic and go off. That would be the best.